Hi Dhatri, good morning.
Good morning Pragna, where are you going?
To the cluster sharing meeting, what about you?
Yeah, I am also going there. Come, let's go.
Yeah, it's getting late, let's go.
Oh Dhatri, Pragna, are you chatting here? It's time up, let's move to class.
Sure sir, looks it's already started.
Good morning everyone. Welcome to the session. Today in this webinar will be to make things seem less complicated and easy to transact in the classroom.
So, Asha, does grammar even matter while learning any new language?
Good question, Dhatri. I wouldn't want to take a call on this one. Shall we ask our audience today? We have a very experienced audience today. Shall we ask them what they think?
Sure.
So, dear friends, here is a question for you. We'd like to start with this one. For language learning, does grammar really matter? Is your answer a yes or a no? Please place your answer in the chat box. We'd like to really know your view.
ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಇದು ಒಂದು ಚಾಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಒಂದು ಭಾಷೆಯನ್ನು ಕಲಿಯಲು ಗ್ರಾಮರ್ ಬೇಕೇ ಬೇಡವೇ? ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನು ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಿ. ಎಸ್, ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಎಸ್, ನೋ. Yes, no, it's going on. So many participants giving answer. Yes, ಹೌದು, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿದೆ.
Actually, Aditya, there is no right or wrong answer for this question. Don't you agree?
Yes, 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 Asha. Yes, Asha.
Everybody has their own view.
Yes.
Grammar is actually one of the basic aspects we all learn to produce and arrange words into sentences. We unconsciously use grammar all the time whenever we are speaking a language, don't we?
Yes, Asha.
We use it for speaking, listening, reading, and writing. But when we study languages, these are like the rules of the game. We need to know them before we actually go into learning a language or teaching the same language to somebody else. Don't you agree?
Yes, yes.
Shall we move on and look at the topics for the day? Friends, today's topics are, we are going to be looking at the present continuous tense, simple present tense, WH questions, and a very interesting topics of homophones. As we all know, any language rests on the pillar of words. There are different kinds of words in English. You have nouns, you have adjectives, you have adverbs, you have verbs, prepositions. All of these words fall together meaningfully to form sentences. And of course, sentences can be of different types. But the basic structure for any language rests on the trunk of root of words. So what actually goes to making a perfect sentence?
Dhatri, do you know what makes a complete sentence?
I feel a sentence which gives a meaning, which gives a full meaning is a complete sentence. Still, I want you to add some more information, Adiba.
To make a complete sentence, first, it should have a subject. We all know that the subject is that part which names the person or thing we are speaking about. Next is the predicate. Predicate is that part which tells something about the subject. And we also have punctuation. Punctuation is a mark such as full stop, comma, question mark, exclamatory mark, etc. Capitalization. The first letter of the sentence should be in capital and ends with a full stop. Let me give an example. The train is crossing the plains. Here, the train is the subject. Is crossing the plains is the predicate, and the word crossing is the verb. And punctuation, we can see that the first letter is in capital and it ends with a full stop. Dhatri, can you give me an example?
Yes, I'm talking to you, Adiba.
Yes, you're right.
So, all these elements are always required to make a complete sentence?
Yes, of course.
That's again a good thought, Dhatri. Shall we ask our audience again what they feel? Here's another one for you, my friends. The shortest grammatically correct sentence in the English language is A go, B high, see bye, or D, hello. Again, I request you to please answer in the using the chat box, which is the shortest grammatical correct sentence in the English language.
Dear teachers, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೇವಲ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಗಳಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸ್ಬೋದು, ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ರೂಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಚಾಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಸೀ ಎ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್.
ಐ ಆಮ್
ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರಿವೀಲ್ ದಿ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ಆದಿತ್ಯ.
ಯಾ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್, ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್: ಗೋ, ಹಾಯ್, ಬಾಯ್, ಹಲೋ. Go is the right answer. Why means the word go, word or sentence go is followed by an punctuation mark, that is exclamatory marks. Then option A, go is the right answer. Thank you. Adiba, could you explain what tenses are?
In the last webinar, we have learned a lot about tenses. Let's recall it. Tenses tells the time period that the action happens in. They rest on the three pillars of the timeline, that is past tense. Past tense tells about something that had happened already. Present tense tells us about something that's happening in present time. And future tense tells us about something that will happen in future. Now, let us look at the present continuous tense from the present tense family. Dhatri, can you tell me what's happening in this picture?
Yes, Adiba. I see a book and its pages are flipping.
Yes, the pages of the book are flipping. It denotes that an action is still going on. So, present continuous tense suggest the action that's going on. It is used to express the things that are happening at the moment of speaking. Here are few more examples. Let us see the examples. Dhatri, can you tell me what do you see here?
I see a telephone which is ringing.
Yeah, the telephone. You can see the telephone is ringing. Yeah, the telephone on the sofa is ringing. The telephone on the sofa is ringing. Here the verb is ring and ing is added to it. It shows an action occurring now. ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಿಯೆ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರಿಯೆ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರೋದನ್ನ ಯಾವ್ದು ಸೂಚಿಸುತ್ತೋ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್. Let us look at another example. The teddy bears are playing on the seesaw. The teddy bears are playing on the seesaw. Here also play is the verb and ing is added to form the present continuous tense.
Okay, this brings us to a poll question now. Read the sentences below and pick the incorrect one. My suggestion to you is there are four options here. Please remember the correct answer to this question is actually the incorrect sentence. Option A is I am playing tennis a lot lately. Option B is I is always reading medical books. C, he is going to have a row. And D, I am dying for a coffee. Please make a note of which is the correct answer to this question, and when the poll question appears, please answer in the poll box and press submit. Aditya, would you like to share the answer with them?
Yes, Asha. 74% of you teacher answer choosing option B. Here, personal pronoun I does not agree with the helping verb is. This makes the sentence wrong. So your answer or option B is right. Asha, shall we have one more poll question?
Sure, Aditya. So now that you've got the hang of it, let us look at another question, shall we? Read the sentences below and pick the incorrect one. Please note incorrect answer. The incorrect sentence is the correct answer to this question. He is always watching his watch. I am trying to forget all about this. I am having my hair done once a month. We visit the museum today. Again, pick your answer and wait for the poll question to appear. Then submit your answer in the poll question box.
ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡದ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಇದನ್ನ ಗುರುತಿಸಬೇಕು, ನೀವು ಆಯ್ಕೆಯನ್ನ ನೀವು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ ತಪ್ಪಾಗಿದೆ. ಯಾವುದು ನಮ್ಮ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ಅನ್ನ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾ ಡಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದ್ಸರಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡಿ. ವಿ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಬ್ ಆರ್ ಬರಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಐ ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಸೇರಿ ವಿಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಡಿ. ವಿ ಆರ್ ವಿಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಂ ಟುಡೇ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಷನ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ನೌ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಲುಕ್ ಆನ್ ಸುಧಾ ಅಂಡರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ.
ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ಸ್. The activity is to identify the present continuous tense from the given sentences, and you have to count them and answer. So let us join Sudha at her home this evening. My name is Sudha. This is our house. I'm in the hall now. I'm going to the kitchen. My mother is there. She is making dinner. I am very hungry. This is my mother. She is cooking dinner. Hi, Amma. Is dinner ready?
Yes, Sudha. Dinner is ready. Please call your father for dinner.
This is my cat, Subramani. He is sleeping. Wake up, Subramani. Appa is watching TV. Appa, dinner is ready.
Okay, Sudha, I'm coming.
Okay, now just to give you a perspective on this one, please go through the sentences that are there on the screen in front of you and count the number of times the present continuous tense appears in these sentences. I repeat, read the sentences, count the number of times the present continuous tense appears in these sentences. We will be coming up with a question next where your answer has to be the number of times the present continuous tense appears in these sentences. Take a moment to look at it. Look at the pictures in my house. How many sentences in present continuous tense can you identify? 6, 5, 3, or none. Remember, we make the present continuous by using the present simple of be, the verb, plus an ing, as in the example, is cooking. So Sudha's mother is cooking.
This is one chat question. ಈ ಹಿಂದಿನ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಪತ್ತೆ ಹಚ್ಚಿ ಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ತುಂಬಾ ಜನ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಚೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಿ, ಏಕೆ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ತು ಅನ್ನೋದಾದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ 6 ಅನ್ನೋದು ಸರಿಯಾದ ಉತ್ತರ. ಯಾವ್ದ್ಯಾವ್ದು ಇತ್ತು? ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್, ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್, ಕುಕಿಂಗ್, ವಾಚಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಲೀಪಿಂಗ್, ಕಮಿಂಗ್. ಎಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ರೈಟ್. ತುಂಬಾ ಜನ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ನ ಚೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಿ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್. ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಡೆಫಿನೈಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವರ್ಬ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ habits, general truths, unchanging situations, giving instruction, and so on. In this topic, we are getting clearer understanding of present simple. It comes with own set of rules. It is not simple as its name. Before move on to rules, we should know some examples to reveal what the teaching pedagogy teaches. Here, known to unknown, simple to complex, example to rules. Pragna?
Yes, Aditya.
Have a look on this picture.
Yes.
What do you see here?
I think he is exercising.
Yes, Pragna, he is doing exercise. This is his regular practice. That is, it is called as habit. ಹೌದು ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ದಿನನಿತ್ಯದ ಹವ್ಯಾಸಗಳನ್ನ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಈ ಚಿತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಐ ಎಕ್ಸರ್ಸೈಸ್ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇದೆ. ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ, ಕುಡ್ ಯು ಶೇರ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್?
ಐ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಅಟ್ 5 AM, ನೋ 6 AM ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ.
ಹಿ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಟೀ ಅಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್. ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ಹರ್ಡ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ಸ್? ಎಸ್. For saying facts which are always true, we use simple present. Example, Bangalore is a metropolitan city. Pragna?
Honey is sweet.
The sun rises in the east. Unchanging situations. Unchanging situations are not changed frequently. It will remain constant for many more days. Example, Delhi is a large city. Pragna?
Bangalore is a large city.
Yeah, you give another one example.
Okay, we catch the bus every morning.
Right. I play cricket every Sunday. These are all the example for unchanging situations. Dear friends, as a teacher, we are using set of instructions in our classroom situation to give instruction. Do you observe how many instruction we are giving day to day classroom management? Yes. Here, go straight and turn left. It's one example with us. Pragna?
Open your English textbook.
Yeah. Read page number 20. Look at the words below and choose the correct sequence to form a sentence. Here, 7 box with us. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the corresponding the word is leave, full stop, big, house, they, in, a. Ill erad option ide, a, 5, 1, 6, 7, 3, 4, 2. Option B, 5, 1, 2, 6, 7, 3, 2. Remember, this is a poll question. Please select your answer through the poll. ಇದು ಜಂಬಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ನೀವು ಡಿಕೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎಗೆ ಬಿಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ವರ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ಡಿಕೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಯು ಸಬ್ಮಿಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪೋಲ್ ಬಟನ್. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೋಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೆನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಕೋಡ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್. 90% ಆಫ್ ಯು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಎಸ್, ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ರೈಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡಿಕೋಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಗೆ ಡಿಕೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎಗೆ ದೇ ಲೀವ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಬಿಗ್ ಸಿಟಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಗೆ ಡಿಕೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಲಿವ್ ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಬಿಗ್ ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಚೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಟೀಚರ್. ಆಶಾ, ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಪೋಲ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್?
ಯೆಸ್ ಆದಿತ್ಯ, ವಿ ಡು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು. ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್. ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಚೂಸ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅ sentence. You have two options, A and B, a sequence of numbers. Again, I suggest you write it down and enter it in the poll question when it appears.
B, 80% of the teacher selected B is the right answer. If we decode for B, she goes to the market almost every day. Really, teachers, you are doing a good job. B is the right answer. Hadiba, could you explain simple present spelling rules?
Yes, Aditya. The simple present tense rules for third person singular are, the first rule is add s to most verbs. Verbs like close become closes, love loves, stop stops, dance dances. And the example is, he closes the door before going to work. The second rule for simple present tense is add es to verbs ending in s, x and z, sh and also sh and ch. Wash, washes, teach, teaches, dress, dresses, relax, relaxes, buzz, buzzes. You can see the examples here. She teaches me at home. Another example, it washes many clothes at once. The third rule is change Y to I and E, add ES to verbs ending in a consonant plus Y. Carry. Here, before Y, there is R, that is a consonant. And so, carry become carries, study, studies. Example is, he carries luggage at the railway station. My friend studies hard using many books.
I keep 6 honest serving men. They taught me all I knew. Their names are what and why and when and how and where and who. Rudyard Kipling.
These beautiful lines are written by Rudyard Kipling in his book Just So Stories as early as 1902. Dhatri, do you remember who Rudyard Kipling is?
Yes, but Adre Iga or Nenapakta Illa, can you recall anything from his writings?
He is the famous English poet, novelist who is the author of The Jungle Book.
I remember. I love Jungle Book cartoon as well.
Yes, everyone loves it.
The WH verbs are basically used to form questions in English, and they form an important part of the English language. The first of these is who, as in, who is this?
He is a gardener. Who is used to ask about a person?
The next one is what? What is he doing?
He is watering the plant. What asks about something?
The third one is where. Where does the gardener work?
He works in the garden. Where asks about a place?
The fourth one is why. Why is he watering the plants?
Why is used to ask about a reason.
The last of the WH, authentic WH questions is when. When does he do it?
He waters the plant every day. When is used to ask about a time?
Generally, how you can say is not part of the WH verbs, but it is added in the set because it gives more context. How is the plant growing?
It is growing very fast. How asked about the manner, condition or quality?
These set of words, oh my God, look at who is here. Who is this?
He is Mr. Bean, isn't he?
Right, what is he doing?
Oh, he is riding on a roller coaster.
But why is he sleeping?
He can sleep anywhere.
When did he fall asleep?
He fell asleep as soon as he climbed on the ride.
Where is this roller coaster?
It is in an amusement park.
How is the roller coaster moving?
It's moving very fast.
if you look at this, this can be used as a classroom transaction for children too. All children love Mr. Bean.
Snehitare, here one chat question with us. Dash, do you take English class? Question mark ide. Idukond answer kuda substitute agide. Because I want to improve my speaking. Option A, why? Option B, where? Option C, when? Option D, how? ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಉತ್ತರಗಳನ್ನ ನೋಡಿ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಬ್ಲಾಂಕಿಗೆ, ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ತುಂಬಾ ಜನ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎನ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಿ. ಎಸ್, ವೈ ಡೂ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ರೀಸನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮೈ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ತುಂಬಾ ತುಂಬಾ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್, ತುಂಬಾ ಸರಿಯಾದ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನ ನೀವು ಆಯ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ. ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ,
ಎಸ್ ಅದಿತ್ಯ,
do you have many more classroom activity with you now?
Yes, let me
share with
everyone. Share
with us.
Yes, so friends, here we have some classroom activities for the WH question marks. So here one, here you can see a chart here, and this is having all the WH question marks. This can be played as a game with students. So idu prashnege prashne anta. So one has to play with me. Dhatri, will you play with me?
Sure, Pragna.
Okay, so here I'll ask you one question. So you need to answer to that question with another question using the WH word which is given in the list here.
Okay.
But one condition is there, that you need to include your answer as a clue in your question. So one trial, you will get to know how it is. Okay. So let me ask you, who is your best friend?
Okay, my answer should be like nanna prashne roopadalle answer na kodbeku alva?
Yes. Adre adralli nimma uttaranu include agirbeku.
Okay, where is Preeti?
Okay, you are getting it correctly. So here you have used the WH question word where, anadanna use maadi ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರ, ಬಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಗಾಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ನಾಟ್ ಮೀ. ಶಾಲ್ ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್?
ಶೋರ್ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ.
ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟೂತ್ ಬ್ರಷ್?
ವೈ ಡೂ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗರ್ಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಪಿಂಕ್?
ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಟು ಲೈಕ್ ಪಿಂಕ್. ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಪ್ಲೇ ದಿಸ್ ಗೇಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಡಿಯನ್ಸ್? ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ. ಸೊ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಫ್ರೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಅನದರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಸೊ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ WH ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಇಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫೇವರೇಟ್ ಕಲರ್? ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತರ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊತೀನಿ. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫೇವರೇಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್. ಒನ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ framing another WH question using another WH question word. So everyone, someone has given here red. Okay, I got your answer, but I request you to frame a question including this red as a clue for your answer. Okay, where is my white dress? Yeah, it's a nice one. Answer, we are getting it from Shanta madam. So I request everyone to frame few more questions here. What color is the sky? Okay, this is again one question, but it is not having, okay, it is having a clue. So why do you like? Okay, so many answers we are getting here. So some are giving direct answers, some are framing questions. So this can be a fun game activity which can be played with the 6th or 7th grade students. So anyway, they love framing questions. So yavaglu kelta irtare yenu yake hege ee tara prashnegalna makkalu yavaglu keltane irtare. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಉತ್ತರನ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲೇ ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಫನ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೆಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಆನ್ ಎನಿ ವಾಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಹೌಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ಡ್, like bedroom, bathroom, living room, and some of the list of household items, those they are there in the house are also listed. This is just to make easy for the students to frame questions. So I'm asking one question to Dhatri here. So where is the car?
Car is in the garage.
Okay. So you can look here. Car is in the garage. Where is the refrigerator?
A refrigerator is in the kitchen.
Okay. So this also can be used as a classroom activity. So let's move on to another activity, Dhatri. Yeah. This you need to play with me. It's a toptastic game board game. And here we need a dice. Hope you have it, Dhatri. So just you need to roll the dice. And here we have list of WH question words inside box and some words to frame questions. So let's play now. You'll get an idea how to play this with students. Okay. So it's your turn now. First you roll the dice and see and tell me what you are getting.
Okay, I'm rolling now.
Okay.
Ayyo, I got one.
Only one. Okay, no worries. Start from the start point and just move one house. So okay. Your word is your teacher. You need to use the word your teachers, words your teacher, and pick any word from the inside list, inside WH question word list.
Okay.
Yes.
Who is your favorite teacher?
All are my favorite ones. Though your question is right. Yeah. So it's my turn now. I'll roll the dice. Okay, I'm getting 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm getting the word vacation. I'm pairing it with where. So where are you planning for a vacation?
Okay, interesting.
So it's your turn now. You roll it once again.
Okay, I have another chance. Okay. Oh, this time I got 2.
2, okay. So in the first attempt you got 1 from there. You need to move 2 houses, 1 and 2. So now your word is pets. Just pair it with any word from the inside box.
Okay. When are you going to show me your pets?
Oh, I have only one pet, Dhatri. Do come home, I'll show you.
Okay.
So, Snehitre, this is also one board game for the students, and we know that they love rolling the dice. So, idu tumba enjoy martare. ಈ ರೀತಿನ ಅವರು ಯಾರು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮುಗಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಆಸ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಎಚ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಧಾತ್ರಿ ವಾಟ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್
ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫೈಟಿಂಗ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಇವನ್ ಐ ಫೀಲ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಫೈಟಿಂಗ್ But the bear, I think the reason for fight is the bear and the deer are fighting here. And I think the bear ate 8 apples. That's why both of them are fighting. So here, the deer is saying that I'll fight with you with my bare hands. And the bear is saying, oh dear. So I'd like to ask this to everyone that what comes to mind when we see such picture or any spelling, I cannot say it's a mistake, any spelling which mismatch they can able to identify in this picture. So I request everyone to chat in the chat box. Do they find any spelling here that can be made corrected or which can suit the picture very correctly? I'll fight with you. I'll fight you with my bare hands. Still, our friends are answering to old question. I request everyone to look at the screen, and we have a very beautiful picture here of a bear and a deer. Both of them are fighting, and what both of them are saying to each other. We can have a look and can say what can be corrected in this chart. Okay. So Sangamesha sir is answering that bare hands, it has to be bare hands, B-A-R-E. But I can see here the deer is wearing the bear's hand, I think. See, Something he is wearing on his hands. So that's why he is saying, we don't know. So let's see what both of them are trying to say. Here we can see a picture. Here V-E-A-R. Bear refers to the, this spelling refers to the animal V-E-A-R. It is the prani. And when I say barefoot, D-A-R-E. Bear. Andre jothege yenu illa kali anta. So barefoot. And here you can see a bear, animal. So though the sound is same, but the meaning is entirely different. So same thing with deer and deer. Here you can see a deer picture and someone is writing as dear friend. We are getting almost all the correct answers. And hope everyone is getting the clue, like to which chapter we are going to cover in our webinar now. So yes, everyone, I think is everyone's guess is right. So here we have homophones. Such words are called homophones. Dhatri, have you ever heard of homophones?
No, Pragna. I have heard about telephone, mobile phone. Can you tell me about homophone?
Homophone. That just now we saw some of the homophones here. Though the pronunciation is same for both the words, but the spelling is different. And the meaning is also different. So homophones are the pair of words that sound the same but have distinctly different meaning and different spelling. So understanding homophones is an essential part of learning English language, both for vocabulary building and spelling. We'll see some of the examples for homophones. So few more examples are here. So this is hare, H-A-R-E. Here again, it's an animal. And H-A-I-R, hair. So this is floor. Yeah. One more example we can see here. Blue, B-L-U-E, blue. It refers to color and B-L-E, blue. So let me tell you the history of homo. Homo comes from a Latin word, homos, which means same. The Greek word phone, which means sound. Hence, we have the word homophone.
Pragna, I see a word, some words like a bar, has the same spelling and same sound, but the meaning is totally different. Are these also homophones?
Yes, definitely. But we can categorize them as homonyms. We can call them as homonyms. Homonyms are the words which have the same spelling, same pronunciation, but have a different meaning in different sentences. Like, see, we'll see some examples so that we'll get a clear idea. So here you can see a picture of a bank, which refers to the bank is a place where we do all our financial transactions. And here river, you can see river and bank of the river we can see. So fly, flying in the sky and is household fly. So a few more examples we'll see. Yeah, the picture itself is saying there are two meanings for this word. Seal, palm, and bat. These are also a few of the homonyms. And here a few of our friends are giving answers in the chat box.
Okay.
Okay, some are giving examples for the homophones. Everyone is giving examples for the homophones in the chat box. We'll see it. Yes, shall we move? Yes. So here we have a classroom activity again. We have a list of words here. Clues are given across and down. Students have to pick, students have to see the clue and then put the correct homophone in the respective box. For example, we have given here sent, S-E-N-T, sent, and C-E-N-T. So they have to again pair it with, they have to find the homophones in the given list. So C-E-N-T and S-E-N-T. Both the words same, sound the same, but have different meanings.
It brings us to the poll question for the homophone section. The king died, dash. The options you have are hairless, B, airless, C, hairless, and D, it could also be airless. I suggest take a moment, read the options, and the poll question will appear on your screen. Please answer in the poll question box.
Snehitare, illi ondu poll question ide. The king died. Ide. Option A, hairless. Option B, hairless. Option C, hairless. Option D, hairless. ನೀವು ನೋಡಿ ಇದು ಹೋಮೋಫೋನ್ಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನ ಕೊಡಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪೋಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಕ್ಷಣ ಕಣ್ಣು ಮುಚ್ಚಿ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಅಲೈಕ್.
ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಯೆಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ರೀಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಅ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಎಚ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ಇ, ಯು ಸಾ ಇಟ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್. ಎಚ್ ಎ ಐ ಆರ್, ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ನೋಸ್, ಹೇರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಹೆಡ್. A-I-R is air, which we breathe, and H-E-I-R is basically a child. So the king died, dash, please choose your correct option, put it in the poll box and press submit.
Tumba jana answer anna kottidiri, illi matte ondu sanna interpretation kodtini. Hairless andre mola illade, innond airless andre childless. ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಹುಡ್ ಬಿ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ, ಮಗು ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ರಾಜ ಸತ್ತು ಹೋದ ಅಂತ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೇರ್ಲೆಸ್, ಹೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಹೇರ್, ಅದಿಲ್ದಲೆ ಅಂತ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೇರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗಾಳಿ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಅಂತ. ಇದನ್ನ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೀವು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀರಿ, ತುಂಬಾ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್.
ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮೀ, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು. ನೌ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದೀಸ್ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್, ಟೇಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್, ರೀಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಅ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಿಸ್. So please take a moment, just look through it, read through it. Give them a moment, Datri. Please read through the lyrics. These are the lyrics to the song you just saw. And if you notice, there are a lot of, you will find homophones were there. Okay, now I'm going to ask you the question. Datri, can we have the question?
Yes.
Okay. Now my question to you is, in the lyrics that you just read, how many grammar concepts did you see that can be taught using this song? We saw the lyrics of the song just come on the screen. How many grammar concepts did you actually see in the lyrics that can be used, that can be taught in a classroom, taught using the song? There's no right or wrong answer to this. Your options are there. You could maybe get more of these. You would find maybe less. I myself found quite a few. I'm sure all of you also experienced, you'll find a lot of them. Your options that are there are 1, 12, 25, and 30. Please answer in the chat box. I myself could find very few. But as teachers, you would have found a lot of them. Again, there's no right or wrong answer for this question. But we put together a small list. Natri, can we have the list, please?
Yes.
We put together a small list of the concepts that show up in the lyrics when you look at it quickly as we showed it to you. There were nouns like bear, life, and pair. We had pronouns, I and you. There were contractions, don't and they'll. You had verbs, pick and break. You had singular and plural, worries, types of sentences, adjectives, prickly paw and raw paw paw. And of course, homophones. All of you would have got that, I hope, bear and bear. There were verbs like will and have, auxiliary verbs. We had punctuation marks, conjunctions, prepositions, but I'm sure all of you would have found many more. This is also one way of, you know, teaching these concepts. Recognition of these things in the classroom. It can be used for that also, to facilitate that. And children would enjoy it because this is a very, very popular song. We'd like to actually leave you with a small reflective question. Do you think, as teachers, the focus of grammar instruction should always be in a direct teaching of rules? Do you agree or you disagree? and you answer in the chat box. We're really interested in what you think. Do you think the focus of grammar instruction should always be in a direct teaching of rules?
ಇದು ಒಂದು ಓಪನ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ತರ ಇದು. ದ ಫೋಕಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರಾಮರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ರೂಲ್ಸ್. ಅಗ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿ? ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಚಾಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಿ. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ರೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಯರ್. ಆಶಾ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದು ಸರಿ ಮತ್ತು ತಪ್ಪು ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಒಂದು ಓಪನ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್. ಓ, ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಯು ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಗ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿ with your answer, you are justified why it is agree and why it is disagree. Really, I am happy. Thank you.
ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೀ ಜರ್ನಿ ಸೋ ಫಾರ್. ಏನನ್ನ ಕಲ್ತ್ವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್, WH ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್, ಮತ್ತೆ ಹೋಮೋಫೋನ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಈ ಸೆಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಇನ್ನೂ ಕೆಲವಿಷ್ಟು ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ಟೀಚೋಪೆ ಆಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲಗಳನ್ನ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪರಿಚಯ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಈ ದಿನ ಕಲ್ತಿರೋ ಅಂತಹ ಪರಿಕಲ್ಪನೆಗಳು, ನಾವು ಕೆಲವು ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಲವಾರು ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಕಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು WH ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಹಾಗೆ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್, ಶಬಾಲೆ, ದ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್, ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್, ಲೆಗ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಪ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪರಿಕಲ್ಪನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಈ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾನು ಆರ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಟೀಚೋಪಿಯಾ ಆಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಲ್ದೇನೆ ನಾವು ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸಹ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು ನಮ್ಮ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ಗೆ ಬಳಸ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಇದು ಕನ್ನಡ ಮತ್ತು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಎರಡು ವರ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಯಾವುದೇ ಮೀಡಿಯಂಗೂ ಅದನ್ನ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರಗಳು.